San Francisco, well done, sir. San Francisco out on the West Coast. Any Australians in the audience? They're all at the bar probably, aren't they? I don't want to leave them out, so here's their international leading airport. I often ask why I got interested in aviation. My father is half Iranian and my mother is Irish, so as you can imagine, most of our family holidays when we were children were spent in customs. And we had this guy turn up at check-in, and he had this scruffy little runt of a dog, okay, on a piece of string for a lead. He walked up to the check-in girl, and he said, I'd like to check myself, and I'd like to check my dog in. She took one look at him and one look at the dog and said, I'm sorry, sir, we don't carry dogs. He thought about it for a minute, and he goes, it's all right, it's a guide dog. She looked at him, she looked at the dog, and she said, well, guide dogs are normally Labradors or Retrievers. Quick as a flash, he goes, why, what have they given me? I was speaking at a software conference last week, and there was all the people that own these software companies, and I said, how many of you would be happy sitting on a plane that your software engineers had written the software for? Apart from one guy who stuck his hand up. And I said, you're quite happy sitting on a plane that your software engineers had written the software for? He goes, yep, wouldn't even start. And the captain said, I'm going to have a long hot bath. He said, I'm going to have a double gin and tonic. He said, and I'm going to make mad, passionate love to that cabin crew girl sat at the back. Everybody turned around, and she'd gone bright red. She took off her seatbelt, and she went charging down the aisle, and she tripped over in front of the first row. And this little old lady bent over and goes, there's no need to rush. She's got to have a bath and a gin and tonic first.
It would be fantastic if we got somebody from the audience to reenact the famous cabin crew safety briefing.
Now, obviously, you know, we're very sensitive about safety and security here, right? So what we're going to do is we're just going to make sure you're escorted and where your hive is best, all right? Please stand the safety guard in the seat pocket in front of you. Position in. That's the brace position, not the Bryon toilet position. There may be 50 ways to leave you low, but there are only 6 to leave this aircraft. There are 2 doors at the front of the cabin. That's the back end. 2 doors at the front. And 2 overwing exits. Low level lighting will guide you to the exit nearest you. Inflate by firmly pulling on this toggle. Please don't do this. Too late. There we go.